Hey everyone and welcome to another video. Today I'm going to talk about all the book series that I'm currently in the middle of because there are kind of a lot. I have studied a lot of book series and that's why I start a lot of them. But since there are so many, it sometimes takes me a while to actually finish them. I've counted and at the moment, if I'm not mistaken and if I'm not like missing anything out, I'm in the middle of 15 book series. Some of those book series I just haven't finished yet, but others I cannot finish because not all the books in these series have been published yet. But with all the book series I'm going to talk about today, I am intending to continue with them and hopefully finish them. So yeah, basically, let's just start with this video. The first one is the Queen of the Tierling series by Erica Johansson. I read the first book, The Queen of the Tierling, almost 2 years ago and I still have not continued with this series. I actually do own the second book, I just still haven't picked it up yet. And I don't really know why. I don't know why it takes me so long because like I really did enjoy the first one, like I liked it. But at this point I don't really remember that much of the first book, but I still want to continue with it. The opinions on this book series are very mixed. Some really hate it, some really love it. And I don't know if I'm going to finish the entire trilogy, but I really do want to read the second book to see what I think of it like 2 years later now. Yeah, I don't know what it's taking me so long with this one and I probably won't pick it up anytime soon because I just have absolutely no desire or plans to continue with it on like short-term notice. But I'm still not DNFing it. I will give it a chance eventually somewhere in the future. Then next I have the His Dark Materials trilogy by Philip Pullman. I've read the first book, The Northern Lights, and the second book, The Subtle Knife, but I still have to read The Ember Spyglass. And again, I don't know why it's taking me so long to pick this book up, except for the fact that I just haven't felt a particular desire to read it like for a very long time. I read the first two books like very quickly after each other and I really enjoyed them, but they did take a little bit of time to get through, so that's why I did not want to pick the third book up immediately. But now it has been like 8 months and I really do want to finish this series because with this series, if I finish the last one, I have finished the entire thing. But the last one is also the biggest one, so it will probably take me a while to get through it. So again, a series I will continue with and I will finish it because there's only one book left, but I don't know when. I don't think it will be very soon. I think my goal will be to finish it at least in 2018. I think that should be manageable because we still have like 7 months left, so yeah, that should be doable. Then next I have the Cormorant Strike series by Robert Gilbert, also known as J.K. Rowling. This is a series of detective books and they follow Cormorant Strike and his assistant Robin while they solve cases. And so far there have been 3 books published in this series and I've read all 3 of them, so I am up to date with this one. But there is going to be a 4th book and I believe J.K. Rowling said on Twitter that it would be out later this year. I believe it's called Little White. And I'm so excited to read that one because I loved like these books so much. Like I love J.K. Rowling's writing just so much. And all these books do have their own story, like they have their own murder case, but there's also a continuation with like Cormorant Strike and Robin and their stories. And I also very much love that when it's like a series with separate stories but also like a continuing story. And I love this one so much. I love thrillers so much. I love detective books so much, so I cannot wait to continue with this one. But I think I have to wait a little while, hopefully not too long. But yeah, this is definitely one series I will continue with, like I cannot wait. And then the next book series that I am currently reading is the Daughter of Smoke and Bone series by Lainey Taylor. I read the first book, Daughter of Smoke and Bone, like 2 months ago. I read it during the latest edition of the 24-hour readathon by Zoe. And I did a whole vlog about it, so, and if you have seen that vlog, you know that I love this book very much again. But still, I've only read the first book and I haven't picked up the second book yet. And again, I don't really know why. I guess it's just time, like there's only so much time and so many books I want to read. And then sometimes the series that I start that I really love like get shoved back on my TBR list. Like now that I'm talking about it, I'm thinking, oh man, I really need to continue with this because I loved it so much. This is a series that has been completely published, so I can finish it and I also own all 3 books. Yeah, also a series that I am planning to finish at least in 2018. Again, I think that should be manageable. Then I'm also currently reading the Percy Jackson and the Olympian series by Rick Riordan. With this series, I'm going through them very quickly. I bought this book set last month or maybe 2 months ago and I've already read 3 books. You probably know this series, it's very popular. It's about Greek mythology in the modern world and like Greek gods. These are all quite short books and the story are relatively simple. Like they all follow the same pattern of like a quest and an adventure and Greek monsters. I'm loving this series so far, and I think I will finish this one quite soon because I am pretty busy with school at the moment, and this series is just perfect to read during like busier periods because you don't really have to think much about them. You can read them so quickly. They're not difficult stories, so like again, they are perfect for like times like that. And then after I finish the Percy Jackson series, I will also start the Heroes of Olympus series, but of course I have to read this one first. Yeah, loving this world. I always love like big fictional worlds with multiple series, like with the Shadowhunter books for example. So yeah, this is a series I can finally say I will finish soon because it's not that hard to finish, it's not that hard to get through, and yeah, again, I'm really enjoying these books. But then, speaking of Shadowhunters, I also haven't finished yet the Dark Artifices series by Cassandra Clare, and of course that's not because I don't want to finish it, but because the last book in this series, Queen of Air and Darkness, still has to be published. It will be out in December of this year, and I'm so incredibly excited for it. Like, it's my most anticipated release of the year. If you know me a little bit, you know how much I love the Dark Artifices series, especially Lord of Shadows. Like, Lord of Shadows is such an amazing book. I love that one so much. It like blew me away. I will continue with the series as soon as my copy of Queen of Air and Darkness arrives in December. Like, I cannot wait. It cannot be December soon enough for me. Then next I want to talk about the Illuminae Files by Amy Kaufman and Jay Kristoff. I read the first book, Illuminae, not that long ago in April, and I talk more about this book like in my April wrap-up. So yeah, this is the first book in the Illuminae Files trilogy, and all the books are published now, so I can finish it if I want to. But yeah, I loved Illuminae very much. It's an incredibly epic sci-fi story. It's of course a very unique series because the entire story is being told in documents and files and transcripts and all that sort of stuff. As I said, I've only started this series very recently, but I'm very keen on continuing with them. All three books are published, but I don't own the second and third book yet. So I first have to buy them to be able to continue with this series, but I will do that I think soon, I don't know. But yeah, again, it's a series that I love very much, at least the first book, so I will continue with them. Again, I don't know when I will actually continue with them, but somewhere in the future. I really hope the next two books are just as good as Illuminae. Like, I think so because everyone seems to be like raving about them. And yeah, it's the same story with a lot of these books here. I just love the first book very much, and I just want to continue with them, but I don't know when. And then another series that I've read the first book of very recently, back in April, and that is the Raven Cycle series by Maggie Stiefvater. I read the Raven Boys last month, really enjoyed it. This book had a very whimsical and magical atmosphere to it, and the writing style is so amazing. Like, it's really that sort of whimsical, beautiful writing style. Not many authors can pull that off, but Maggie Stiefvater can, and like Lainey Taylor can also do that sort of writing that I just love so much. The entire series is published, and I actually own the entire series. I own all four books, so there's really nothing stopping me from continuing with this series. But again, like, it's time. I don't have enough time to read all the books that I want to read, but I am at least intending to pick up the second book fairly soon. I really don't want to wait too long with this series because I think there are so many things that are going to happen in the next few books, and like, I think this story is going to be so amazing and so beautiful. And yeah, again, another series that I plan on finishing in 2018, at least. And then the next series I'm currently in the middle of is the Diviner series by Libba Bray. Currently there are three books out, but I believe this entire series is going to consist of six books. Correct me if I'm wrong, I'm not exactly sure, but I know that at least there are going to be some more books in this series. Currently I have read The Diviners, the first one, and Lair of Dreams, the second one, and I do own the third book, but I haven't read it yet. And yeah, this is another incredible series, and it's very supernatural, but it's also historical fiction. It takes place in the 1920s in New York City. This series is especially good because of its characters. Like, there's such a diverse cast of characters with backstories, and like, it's just so emotional, and I just love every single one of them. So I still have the third book that I can read, but after that I cannot finish it yet because of course not all the books are out, and I believe it's going to take quite some time for all the books to be published because the third book took quite a while to like get out. So I'm going to read the third book, but I have no rush because it will probably take a while for the rest of the series to come out. So I'm saving like a little bit of the Diviner story for myself for when I'm in the right mood for it. But yeah, again, another incredible series. I can really, really recommend this one. Like, it's really, really good. I just talked about Lainey Taylor, but I completely forgot that, of course, I also haven't finished the Strange Dreamer series by Lainey Taylor yet. But in this case, it is because the second book in this series still has to come out. I believe it's only going to be a duology, but that still counts as a book series for me. But yeah, Strange Dreamer, again, I loved it very much. As I like said before, I love Lainey Taylor very much and her writing style. And this book, oh my god, I need the second one as soon as possible because I need to know what's going to happen next. I believe it will be out in October later this year, so I'll have to wait a couple of months, but it won't be too long, fortunately. And yeah, then I will finish the series and, like, as I said, I cannot wait again. The next series that I've started and I'm currently in the middle of is a bit of a painful subject because it's the Kingkiller Chronicles series by Patrick Rothfuss. And of course, the painful thing with this series is that the third book just doesn't come out, like it just doesn't get published. There's no news whatsoever about the third book and people have been waiting for years and years, and like it's been so long since the publication of the second book. I believe it's been like 7 years or something. So yeah, that's why with this series I've only read the first book, because I love the first book again so much. Like, this is such a incredible book, such an incredible series. The writing, the characters, it's such an amazing fantasy book and I loved it so much. Like, it's so rich and beautiful. So that's again why I'm saving the second book, because once I finish the second book, the wait for the third book will be so painful, especially since nobody knows when the third book is going to be here. So I've started the series, probably won't finish it anytime soon, but that's not my fault. That's because the third book just isn't anywhere to be seen. And yeah, I will read the second book, but I will save it for a little while, just to make the wait for the third book a little bit shorter. And then next I have the Ember in the Ashes series by Sabaa Tahir. I read this book 2 or 3 years ago. I think it's like 2.5 years ago. And I really enjoyed it. And then I read the second book as soon as it came out. But that's also again like 2 years ago or something. And the rest of the books in this series haven't been published yet. But fortunately, the third book is coming out very, very soon. It's coming out in June. Finally, I have been waiting for this for so long. I love this series. I was actually very pleasantly surprised by this series because I didn't really have that many high expectations whatsoever. It sounded a bit weird to me, but it's actually like really, really epic and really cool. It's a fantasy series, but it's like inspired by ancient Rome, and I just love that so much. Cannot wait to see what's going to happen next, but I think I will like need a summary of the first two books because it has been so long since I read them. I don't remember all the details, but I do remember that I love them and I do remember that I want to continue with the series very, very badly. I believe in final it's going to be 4 books. So then we have the third book, and after that there will be a 4th book. And then when that one is out, I have finished it and then it will be amazing. Then I have a couple of series where only the first book is published so far, but I have loved those first books and I will continue with those series once the next books come out. So first of all, I have the Children of Blood and Bone series. I believe this is called the Orisha series. I'm not sure, but any case, this book, you've probably heard of it because it's one of the like most popular releases like in 2018 so far. This book is everywhere. Everyone is reading it. Everyone has read it. Everyone is buying it. Like, it's everywhere. And I've read it too and I loved it very, very much. Like, I was blown away by it. I get why everyone loves it so much, because it is that incredible. I actually met Tomi Adeyemi at YALFest. I got my book signed. So it is personalized and signed. That's so amazing. Like, I met an author of one of my favorite books I read so far this year. Like, that's so, so cool. And this will be a trilogy, and the second book will come out in 2019, and then the third book will probably come out in 2020. Again, releases I cannot wait for. Like, it's going to be so epic, and like this book, this ending, oh my god, I need to know what's going to happen next, because the wait is just so, so unbearable. And then in that same category, I have The Cruel Prince by Holly Black. Also a 2018 release, also the beginning of a new series. I don't actually know if the series has like a specific name. I will just call it like The Cruel Prince series. And with this book, like, I enjoyed it. I don't think it's like an epic masterpiece whatsoever. Like, it has flaws, but it's just a very enjoyable book. Like, it's just fun. And I do really want to know what's going to happen next and where this story is going to take us. So when the next book comes out in January next year, I will buy it, I will read it. And I think it will really depend on the second book for me to decide if I'm going to finish this series. I actually don't know how many books are going to be in this series. Like, I'm guessing 3, because most series are trilogies these days. But like, yeah, this series, it's just fun. It's fun. It's not like my new all-time favorite series, but it's a lot of fun, it's interesting, and yeah, I will continue with it. I'm planning to do so at the moment. And then the last book series that I'm currently reading, that I'm going to talk about today, is not really a book series in the traditional sense, but it still is a series of some sort, and that is the Ladies Janie series by Cynthia Hand, Brody Ashton, and Jodie Meadows. So this is not a series as in that these books are going to be a continuation of each other, but it is a series in the sense that it's written by the same authors and that it's written in the same style and it's like the same purpose. Because in this series, the authors take the story of a well-known Jane and just completely turn it around, make it funny, just make fun of the story, and it's so brilliant. In the first book, My Lady Jane, they take the story of Lady Jane Grey, and they just make fun of history a little bit, and they just make the entire story so funny. And let me tell you, the real historical story of Lady Jane Grey is not funny, so I love how they did that. And then the second book in this sort of series will come out in June, and it's called My Plain Jane, and that one is about Jane Eyre. I believe there's also going to be a third book, so yeah, as I said, it's not a traditional series, but also like sort of a series. And yeah, I just love the concept of this book and of these like books, this series. Again, I cannot wait to get my hands on the second book, and then I will probably read it straight away. So yeah, this is it for all the book series that I'm currently reading. Also, if you missed certain book series in this video, then that's either because I DNF'd them, and I am going to do a separate video about book series I'm not going to finish, like that is going to be like being filmed somewhere in the future, or because I have finished the series, because that happens as well. Like, I'm actually pretty good with finishing series. I finish quite a lot of series. It's just that there are so many book series that I want to read and that I start that I just cannot finish all of them. Or of course I haven't started that series yet. I've like box sets and first books in a series that I've bought but I just haven't read yet. So yeah, lots and lots of book series in my life going on at the moment. But this was it for this video, and if you like this video, please go subscribe or give it a thumbs up, because I would really appreciate that. Please let me know down in the comments what is a book series that you hope to finish this year, and hopefully I will see you again in my next video. Bye!